Brendan, quest for success.
It's the one question that we all want the answer to. We spend a vast amount of our lives searching for this one thing, success. It's one thing that we all want. We want to be successful in our careers. We want to be good parents, good friends. That's to be successful, right? Or maybe some of us want the ultimate success, to be the prime minister or president one day, which, by the way, seems a lot easier than it once was. So that's the good news. What is the secret to success? I'm sure we would all like the answer to it. In fact, today I'll give you an answer to that question. How could I be so confident? That's because I believe I found one of the most successful people living today. That person, you might have heard of them. He is currently the CEO of two major companies. That's two companies. Like, being the CEO of one company seems crazy enough, but he's a CEO of two at the same time. I'm talking about Elon Musk. You might have heard of him before. His first company is called Tesla. So this is the electrical car company. Now, Tesla's claim to fame that they sell luxury electric vehicles to people like you and me. You might have seen them around Calgary. They have a store in Chinook Mall now. And Tesla recently did something pretty incredible, and that was they surpassed another car making company in market cap. They're bigger than this other car company. Maybe you've heard of it, I'm not sure. They're pretty obscure. Ford? Have you guys heard of Ford before? Okay, yeah, maybe not. Ford! Like, this is the company that literally invented the automobile, and Tesla recently surpassed them in terms of size of the company. Isn't that incredible? What about in 2013? The Model S for Tesla became the car of the year by Motor Trend. Once again, Tesla is only 13 years old, compared to Ford, which is 114 years old. Over 100 years difference, and they've been able to accomplish so much in such little time. In addition to Tesla, Elon is also the CEO of SpaceX. Now, SpaceX is no pushover in itself. SpaceX is a private space company which makes money by flying satellites into space for customers and at governments as well. Now, the real impressive thing about SpaceX is that they're able to do something that no other space company has done before, and that is they launched a rocket into space recently. They re-landed the same rocket on Earth, then refurbished it and refired that same rocket back into space. This has never been done before in space history. Think about the past decades. NASA's been firing rockets to the moon and into space, only to then throw them as garbage into the sea. These are billion-dollar pieces of machinery, and somehow Elon has led a company that was able to re-land these rockets and reuse them. To such a point that it's starting to become a reality that people like us might be able to go to space in the next decade, similar to how we can fly to Europe now. It might be just as easy to go to space. I recently read a biography on Elon called The Quest for a Fantastic Future, about his life. Elon's accomplishments are not only incredible, but almost downright unbelievable what he did. And I think there's a lot that we can learn from him for our own lives. Let's see what he did and how he became successful and what we can take away. Even if Elon's success is not the same as ours, I think we can all agree that it's downright very impressive and we can take something away from it. So let's start off with a little analogy. I'm gonna start here on the launch pad. So imagine you're at the launch pad for a space flight. You look all around you, you see concrete. You crane your neck up to see a pristine white rocket standing in front of you. You're about 100 meters away from it, you can see the liquid oxygen starting to boil off on the ground just as the rocket's getting ready to take off. This is Elon's early life, I'm going to start with. Now, the one point I'd like to make is that he's actually quite similar to all of us. Elon, although he brought back engineering and innovation to the U.S. when it was stymied for a little bit, he's actually not an American-born citizen. He was born in South Africa. He wasn't born into any fame. He didn't have famous parents. He didn't have outlandish amount of money. He was just born into a normal family. Elon then went on to move to Canada, where he went to Queen's University, in fact, for a couple of years, before then transferring to Penn State to finish off his degree. In all portions of Elon's early life, it's actually quite boring, to be honest, which kind of gives me confidence because any of us in this room don't have more advantages than he had, but look where he ended up. Why can't we do the same? It was in university that Elon started writing papers and essays that had to do with electric cars and electrical infrastructure in the future. So this is where the ideas started to take off. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We just blasted off our rocket. We're leaving the launch pad at incredible speeds. This is the first stage of our launch. Growing up, Elon had visions of electric cars, and it was in university, after university, when he moved to Silicon Valley, that he met future people that he would work with to then form Tesla. Elon had a dream, and he pursued it. He's quoted as saying, "The best minds of my generation are worried about how to make people click ads." Instead of doing this, Elon, he had a deeper meaning in life, and he pursued it. Elon was told multiple times that he was crazy. Think about trying to form Tesla. If you were to do it today, what about 14 years ago? Like, even today, people, leaders of the free world, don't believe in climate change. You think 14 years ago would have been easy to start an electric car company? I don't think so. Everyone was telling him that Tesla would fail. In fact, a popular Silicon Valley magazine voted Tesla as the number one company to fail way back then. But as Elon says, good ideas are always crazy until they're not. We're now in the second stage of the rocket launch. We've let go of the first stage of the rocket. We're firing off into the stratosphere now. This is SpaceX. This is part of Elon's life where he started SpaceX, the space company. Now, when you think about SpaceX, it kind of sounds like a childhood fantasy, doesn't it? Like, you want to be an astronaut someday? Oh yeah, that's kind of cute. But Elon was able to break into this industry, the space industry. Like, how many constraints are on this industry as it is to get into the space industry? The amount of risk that people would take on, government agencies. NASA was the only one to do it for decades. Then they allowed Boeing to come in and start doing some of those projects. And now Elon has this idea to break and shake up the space industry. How did he do it? He read. He read books about how to make rockets. Now, we all know the phrase, it's not rocket science, right? Which is a phrase to say something that is really hard or hard to do. He was literally doing rocket science by reading books. So there to show you, if he can learn the hardest thing by just reading books, what are the things that we can do by just reading and learning up on it ourselves? His strict work ethic demands that he had for himself, he also had for his employees. So he was quoted as one of his employees saying that everything he does is fast. He pees fast, like a fire hose, 3 seconds and he's out. So that gives you an idea of his work ethic and how strongly he worked. The most inspiring part of SpaceX, in my opinion, is that Elon actually stopped the company from going public because it wasn't part of the goal. The goal for SpaceX was to get to Mars. Going public, this would have meant billions of dollars for himself, his closest friends, the people that started the company. But to this day, he's held back. And that is because he thinks that by going public, it'll change the goal of the company. Maybe to make money, maybe for something else, but not to get to Mars. That's pretty admirable, denying some of your closest friends those huge sums of money just because it's not part of the company's goal in the future. Now, after the second stage, our rocket has landed in orbit. We're orbiting around the Earth. We can look back and see that little speck with the blue and the green, basically making out the continents from above. What's next for Elon? He's currently promoting ideas such as the two where cars can enter and be propelled at fantastic speeds to reach intermediate destinations quicker. So a great idea for this would be the Calgary to Edmonton corridor here that we drive on the highway. That 3 hours could probably go down to something like 15 minutes if this idea goes through. So people are working on that. He's also working on solar panels that are roof shingles on a Tesla Model 3, which would be under 30 grand US, so affordable for a lot of us instead of the higher luxury vehicles. And obviously reaching Mars. Overall, what we can learn from Elon is that our secret to success, what the secret of success is that it's defined by each one of us. No one can tell you what your secret to success is. You have to ask yourself deep inside, what is success to you? And then do whatever possible to reach that goal. I truly believe that's what Elon did. He had an idea, he had success in his mind, and he stopped at nothing to attain it against all adversity. Pele, who is a famous soccer player, widely regarded as one of the best soccer players in the game, is quoted as saying, "Success is no accident. It's hard work, perseverance, studying, self-sacrifice, and most of all, loving what you do or what you're learning to do." Think right now of what you want to do, what your ultimate goal is, and do it. Only you can define your own success, and in the end, you will be the only person standing there to determine whether you met your goal or you didn't. Good luck in your quest for success, and after all, a new limit has been set. The sky is no longer the limit. The new limit is Mars. Until next time.